Hello friends, so we are back here with our another video. Now the topic of today's video is Butler House Encounter. What happened to the Butler House Encounter? Why it is in news again? The encounter which occurred in 2008. What happened to the accused? What happened to the person who's come to the injury? Yes, I'm talking about the security person who's come to the injury. There was lots of rumors spread at that time, and lots of people raised the finger over the encounter, and there was a movie also was released over it and starred by the John Abraham. Yes, now the Butler House Encounter is topic is back. Just on 8th of March, the Patiala House Court has given its judgment, and he has convicted the Honorable Court Sanjeev, the judge Sanjeev Yadav has convicted accused Aris Khan alias Junaid. Yes, the same person, the one and only person who was absconding from 2008, right from the encounter time. Aris Khan was the fourth terrorist of IM Indian Mujahideen. He was the IM militant. There were four militants at the encounter site. Out of two were shot dead at the instance of encounter, and there was one more terrorist who was apprehended by the police, and he was sentenced in 2013 life imprisonment. So the video is gonna be longer. It can take around 5, 10 or 15 minutes. Just stay tuned with Hit and Fit Hour. We'll discuss each and every aspect of this video right from the beginning. What happened on the encounter day? What the court judgment said? What are the legal aspect of the court judgment? In which section the court has convicted the accused Aris Khan? Now, who is Aris Khan? What is his background? Whether he studied or not? Everything all about this entire matter. We will not spare any segment of this Butler House Encounter. Yes. So let's start with the present time. On 8th of March, the court has given the judgment over the Butler House Encounter. The accused Aris Khan, he has also his name Junaid. Some people call him as Junaid. So we use the word alias. Okay, alias has been Junaid has been convicted of many charges. He has been convicted with 302 murder, 307 attempt to murder, 333 causing grievous hurt to the public servant, 353 assaulting a public servant while he is doing his official duty. I'll come over it later. Okay, these are the charges on which the court has convinced that Junaid Riaz Aris Khan has played a vital role, and he killed the Inspector Mohan Chand Sarma during the encounter. The various vital evidence were presented by the prosecution so that the last accused can be proved guilty, and the court accepted all the charges were proved beyond reasonable doubt. That's why he has been convicted. Rest amount of imprisonment, amount of the what will be his punishment? The punishment will be given on 15th of March. Yes, 15th of March, the court will pronounce the rest of the judgment over this matter. Okay, so this is the present situation of this Butler House Encounter. What are the aspects which happened before this? Yes, how the Aris Khan, the news suddenly we just came across that Aris Khan has been convicted by the court when he was apprehended. He was apprehended in 2018. He has made some false documents, and he was living since 2008 over the some Nepali. He has made some some identity of Nepali citizens. Right, he was apprehended in 2018 by the police, and he was put behind the so he was just since then all the judicial procedure was continuous till then. Okay, what happened on 19 September 2008 when the encounter occurred? The Delhi police received the Mohan Chand Sarma, the deceased wanted inspector, received the report, and he informed, as we hear this coming with a story of what happened in the Fatla House encounter. So far, a video has already been made by and it was shared by John Abraham, as I told you. We'll come over the various parts, various segments of this Fatla House encounter, right? From the instances of Fatla encounter, there was lots of lore were created over the and lots of finger were raised over this encounter, whether it's a fake encounter or not. Alright, in 2008, what happened? 19 September 2008, Mohan Chand Sharma received input. He, after discussing with his senior, he reached to the spot. He reached to the spot with the other team member, SI Ravinder, SI. There were three more SIs in his team and with head constable. They reached in two vehicles around. In one vehicle, it was a private vehicle of SI Ravinder. Before entering the room where they got information that these were okay. I just need to say that these terrorists were involved in the bomb blast of Delhi, five bomb blasts which occurred in the Delhi, which terribly shocked the entire nation. Yes, they were the role, they were the mastermind of the plan, they were the executioner of the bomb blast which happened in 2008. So the police got the information that the bomb blast supposed to be accused for the militant was hiding in Fatla House. Fatla House, what is Fatla House actually? It's a place in Jamia Nagar in South Delhi, where they were living in a rented home. They were both arrested, and when the police got information about them hiding at that place, they went to the spot. And before entering the entire place, they sent a one policeman in civil dress with the text of some kind of insurance or some kind of Vodafone idea. Yes, some kind of Vodafone executive. He went there, he checked, he came back, he confirmed that yes, there are four terrorists over there. The next time when the police knocked the door, Mohan Chand Sharma knocked the door and introduced himself that he is a police, open the door. The terrorist did not open the door. Meanwhile, the other team of the police, they went to the other side and they checked the other door. So when Mohan Chand Sharma knocked the door, it was bolted from inside. The terrorist didn't open the door. When the other team of this police squad reached to the other gate of that building, after a while, when they were just entered into the room, in between the first room was also opened by the Mohan Chand Sharma forcefully, and the militant blatantly fired upon them. Then there was fire exchange between the police and the militant, and on the spot, two militants were killed and two were. In the same time, Mohan Chand Sharma was stunned to his injuries and he was declared dead by the hospitals. Also, the two militants were also taken to the hospital. They were also shot dead, declared by the hospital. Okay, that was the story of that encounter day. The court also pointed out some these are not to be discussed. What the court said. Well, the information which I am sharing is in public domain. Okay, nothing personal, in my opinion. I am just sharing. I am not raising and pointing any finger towards any professionals or anything. Okay, I am just saying what is into the public domain. I respect the soldier. I respect the Mohan Chand Sharma. He did a brave job. And he did the supreme sacrifice during the execution of his government duty. Okay, that was the that part. Since that day in 2013, the third militant was arrested by the police and he was sentenced to life imprisonment in 2008. The fourth militant, Aris Khan, how he has been convicted? What are the evidence were presented into the court? And let me tell you, Aris Khan, during the entire proceeding, he did not accept any of the allegation over here. He just denied right from the first day. He did just deny. But let me tell you what were the crucial, substantial evidence found by the police which was presented in the court to Marksy. The 10th certificate is Aris Khan was doing B.Tech in the second year. These were the documents which were recovered from the Aris court, and the third event also accepted that he is that person. And also now Aris Khan has also accepted his role. These were the hidden talents. So this is the whole issue, and I have already stated what were the charges which have been which have been against the Aris Khan. Aris Khan was he belonged to district Azamgarh UP, and the scene is from the village. His father was died when he was in 2009. Let me tell you that he belongs to the educated family. His uncle is a former IAS, and his one uncle is also a doctor. So he belongs to well educated and well-settled family. So it's all about the Butler House encounter, which I felt that when the news came, it is not so been. It's not so being spread, it's not, people are not aware, people have just forgot the Butler House. People must have watched the movie, but they are not aware of this, of all this matter. So I thought that I should bring the story of Butler House, and the people who raised the finger over this encounter, I think they get the answer, because there were rumors that some politician who raised the finger and who even went to the family of the accused who were killed during the encounter, but they didn't go to the soldier family, the Mohan Sharma, the inspector who was killed during the encounter. Nobody. There were some politicians who didn't give the respect. When they helped to respect our court, the court has given its judgment, and the court, we all have faithful faith over the tradition. It measures everything with fair and just and efficiently. Correct. Okay, guys, if you feel that there is any other topic which I should cover, I should make video, then you can text me over the comment box. And if you don't like some part of this video, then you can also comment, because I like the text also mine. If anything else, if you would like to share with me, then please write me in the text. Okay, and it's been a long time since I recorded video. It's almost around 2 months. I have not been able to get the time properly, and life is hectic. And also, I'm not able to put some video on the trading. Very soon, part of the trading is also going very well and great. And also, bring some more video and interesting video, so some informative, educational, and stock market relevant video. Also, I'll put very soon. Stay tuned and stay connected.